Hello and welcome to the Power BI April 2022 update. In this video, we'll explore what's new this month and see some demos of the highlights. We have some exciting new updates for you in the reporting section. First, we'd like to remind you that we plan to make the new format pane generally available in the May release next month, after which you will no longer be able to switch back to the old format pane. Please continue sending us your feedback on the monthly release blog post or by adding to the discussion via the Share Feedback link next to the Preview feature checkbox in the Options menu. We've heard overwhelming feedback about the new format pane subcategories and adding extra clicks for authors who are familiar with settings and where to find them. Here at Power BI, we listen to your feedback. And we've responded by adding a user preference setting in the upcoming May release to allow all subcategories to remain expanded when you open a card, which should feel similar to the old format pane behavior. We've also continued to re-add missing formatting options from the old pane, including shape map custom colors, the scatter chart show blank values toggle, the responsive toggle for slider type slices, and button icon size. We've also made some bug fixes and structural changes in the table and matrix cards to improve both flexibility and convenience of formatting. Rosie will take us through a demo of the changes.
I'm excited to show you the new changes we've added to the new format pane for the April release. The first is around matrix borders. In the old pane, if I wanted to add a border just around my row headers, I'd have to find the row headers card and adjust where I want that to show up, and then go back up to the grid card to be able to adjust the color and weight. Now, in the new pane, I can use the grid new borders consolidated card to choose which section would I like the border to show up, and from the same place, update the color and width. Now the next change I'd like to show you is around subtotals and grand totals. Previously in the old pane, we had one place to modify both row and column subtotals. So as I change the color, it updates both. And the same thing happens for grand totals as well. Now, in the new pane, we've split these up by column subtotals, row subtotals, column grand total, and row grand total. Now I can update and modify the styles for each of these separately. Now I'd like to show you the new positions we've added to Legend. Previously in the old pane, we had about 8 options and they were named very similarly. Now in the new pane, we've adjusted some of the naming to make it more clear and added 2 more styles, top right and bottom right.
Next, Tooltips will now support drill actions for matrix, line, and area charts. Last year, we released a preview of a new visual tooltip which allows for data point drill down or drill through actions from the tooltip itself. The initial preview did not include drill support for some built-in visuals, but this month we've added the capability to the matrix, line, area, and stacked area charts. For more information on how to enable the preview feature, check out the documentation in the video description below. Next, we've updated required permissions when using composite models on Power BI datasets. Currently, a user consuming a report which leverages a composite model based on a Power BI dataset requires build permissions on all datasets in the chain. We've heard from you that this is far too restrictive for a user who only needs to consume a report. Now, for datasets in premium or premium per user workspaces, users consuming reports leveraging a composite model based on a Power BI dataset are required only to have read permissions or the viewer role on all datasets in the chain. Next, we've brought error bars to the clustered column and bar charts. Last month, we introduced this feature for line charts to help you visualize the uncertainty in your data. Now we're happy to announce that error bars will be available for clustered column and bar charts as well. You can create error bars using the same method as with line charts. Simply drag upper and lower bound fields into the field wells in the error bars card of the analytics pane. You'll find a more limited set of options than with the line charts. After all, shade areas are not very meaningful with discrete columns. You'll also notice that error bars are enabled specifically for clustered charts and not stacked, where such a visualization would be unclear about the categories being represented. Next, we've been listening to your feedback on the new Bookmark Navigator, and to better support interaction between multiple navigators and bookmark groups, we will now ensure that a bookmark selected on a navigator will continue to stay selected until another bookmark on that navigator has been selected. This will enable the use of multiple navigators capturing separate bookmark groups to effectively have independent active bookmarks. Rianne will take us through a demo of this feature.
We've been listening to your feedback on the new Bookmark Navigator, and we've heard about an unintuitive interaction that we think we can address. Before, the Bookmark Navigator was showing you the last selected bookmark from your whole list of bookmarks. So, you know, it'll show you that you last selected weekend, or last selected 1 to 2 people. And if you last selected 1 to 2 people, then this day of the week navigator would not have anything selected. Now, once you've selected a bookmark in a navigator, it will continue to stay selected until you select another bookmark inside that navigator, whatever group that navigator represents. So now, if I select 1 to 2 people or 3+ people, day of the week won't unselect itself. For context on these changes, let's talk a bit about what bookmarks and bookmark navigators are really doing. A bookmark captures a slice of your report state, so it's a collection of settings, like Sunday plus Saturday on one slicer, that you want to be able to get back to. When you open a bookmark, Power BI looks at that state that was captured in the bookmark and then adjusts to align with that. So again, I click weekend and Power BI says, okay, I will change this slicer to only weekend days. And that's all that changes. Everything else about the report state remains the same. So the bookmark navigator helps you move between those various saved settings, which makes it a convenient way to put that navigation directly onto your report page. And to be able to tie bookmark navigators to groups will help you organize them by the elements that each different group touches. So for example here, there's no overlap between day of the week bookmarks and number of people bookmarks. They capture the states of two totally different visuals. Behind the scenes, Power BI really doesn't care what you do after you select a bookmark. The only thing clicking a bookmark does is get you to one of these states. The navigator, on the other hand, is showing you your last selected bookmark, and it's only doing that as a visual convenience. And so the only thing that this change that we're making now is that it will only watch its own group to show which bookmark has been selected, or which one was the last selected. And if report states overlap between different bookmark groups, like if weekend and number of people both affected fair amount in different ways, then still only the last one you clicked, the last bookmark, will apply. But what we learned is that report designers aren't making reports that way. These different bookmark groups rarely overlap. And so the nice thing about this change is that for practical use, it creates a logical and intuitive experience, which means that I know which of these bookmarks inside their groups is currently applied at all times. We hope you enjoy this change, and we hope that as a result, it makes your report navigation feel a lot more intuitive and seamless than before.
Next, in the data preparation section, we're excited to announce that dynamic mQuery parameters are now generally available. As a refresher, this feature allows report viewers to dynamically set the values for an mQuery parameter using filters or slices. This can be especially useful for people needing query performance optimizations without sacrificing report interactivity. As a part of the GA release, dynamic mQuery parameters are now compatible with the Q&A, decomposition tree, key influences, and anomaly detection AI features. In the data connectivity section, we have several new and updated connectors for you this month. First, the Autodesk Construction Cloud Connector allows customers with unified ACC accounts and BIM 360 accounts to import their data connector extractions directly into Power BI. Data Connector allows teams to quickly extract project data across their entire account, and with this certified connector, customers can now streamline the data extraction process and set a schedule for their Power BI dataset to be updated automatically with the latest data connector extract. This greatly simplifies a customer's ability to gain valuable insights on their project data so they can make more informed business decisions. We've also updated the Digital Construction Works Insights connector to fix an issue where it was unable to connect in the Power BI service. And we've updated the Dremio and Dremio Cloud connectors to allow users to connect to Dremio from the Power BI service without requiring an on-premises data gateway. Next, we have some updates to Power BI goals for you in the service section. First, we're introducing bulk updating capabilities and a helpful access and sharing banner. With bulk updating, you will be able to select multiple goals to make changes to due dates and owners, as well as delete multiple goals at once. We will be rolling out more capabilities in the coming weeks, like status changes, status rules, and more. We've also included a helpful banner that calls out when goal owners do not have access to the scorecard that contains their goals. With a few clicks, you can now ensure that all owners can access and provide updates on their goals' progress, making it easier than ever to keep your scorecard up to date. In the mobile section, push notifications on the mobile apps help you stay up to date with information that requires your immediate attention. In this month's release, we've added two new types of goals-related push notifications to the mobile apps. The first is a notification for when you've been assigned a goal. This ensures you never miss when you've become a goal owner and are now accountable for that goal. The second is notifications for mentions. When you're mentioned in a note attached to a new or existing check-in, you'll receive a notification on your mobile device. Now when someone mentions you, requesting your attention or comment, you won't miss it, and you can reply directly from within the app. For both types of notifications, tapping the notification will take you directly into the relevant goals details pane. Next, we have some new and updated visuals for you in the visualization section. First, the new visuals available for you on AppSource this month are the Animator for Power BI Visual by InnoVista Limited and the Data Label Placement Visual by pbivizedit.com. Updated visuals include the Drill Down Time Series Pro Visual by Zoom Charts and the Power Gantt Chart by Nova Silva. Lastly, we've added support for high contrast themes in Windows 11. Windows 11 introduced four new high-contrast themes, Aquatic, Desert, Dusk, and Night Sky, each with a new color palette distinctive from its counterpart in Windows 10. In this release, Power BI fully supports the new Windows 11 high-contrast themes and is compatible with Windows 10 high-contrast themes and custom themes. Colors of the window background, body text, highlighted text and background, hyperlink, disabled text, button text and background, and icons will adapt to the user's system colors at runtime. As a result, users with low vision will have a smoother experience navigating through the Power BI app and utilizing all kinds of dialogues, regardless of the Windows operating systems they use. And that's all for this month. As always, we hope you enjoyed the updates, and please, join us at community.powerbi.com and also check out our new Power BI community show on the Power BI YouTube channel. And please keep sending us feedback on what you'd like to see in upcoming releases.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next month.